In her speech read by the State Minister for Higher Education, John Christosom Muyingo, during the second graduation ceremony of students at Uganda Petroleum Institute Chigumba in Chiriandongo District, the Minister for Education, Janet Kataham-Seveni, urged the graduates to be innovative and solve the socio-economic problems in their communities.
The graduates to develop a high sense of patriotism and a positive attitude towards work. Go in the field to work with the collective attitude. Above all, I implore you to be innovative in using the skills gained.
Minister Muyingo assured the management of the institute that government is committed at improving the infrastructure and human resource challenges which are currently faced by the institute.
Having staff staying away from the institute has also reduced all their productivity. There is need to, for us to provide additional housing units to accommodate our staff in campus. Honorable Minister, the nature of training demands highly skilled and experienced manpower. The manpower is costly to retain, to recruit and retain.
Be assured that we are aware and something is being done. I therefore, on behalf of government, pledge to fast track all interventions impending the timely implementation of the institute's development agenda and consequently progression to a full-fledged center of excellence.
During the graduation ceremony, Proskovia Nabanja, the chairperson governing council of the institute, called on all Ugandans to join the campaign of environmental conservation by planting trees in their communities.
We must be intentional in fixing our relationship with nature before it fights back. I would like to thank the management and staff of UPIC for embracing this initiative and partnering with Womoja Conservation Trust as well. And I also encourage each and everyone here to support such interventions. What if everyone in the country planted a tree every year?
The graduates got national and international diplomas in upward and downward stream petroleum operations, petroleum engineering, mechanical maintenance, welding fabrication and pipe water operations, among others. Meanwhile, educationists have emphasized the importance of career guidance to students joining higher learning institutions as the only way to reduce unemployment among the youth. According to the research conducted by ISBAT, unemployment among land youth, lack of relevant career guidance to students is the main cause of unemployment.
It is very important for students or the youth to understand that which career they should opt, because going into any career where they have not passion or they don't have interest will not be fruitful for their future endeavors.
ISBAT University organized an open day for all youths from different corners of the country to talk to guide them on different careers and the opportunities available for them to make informed decisions while choosing courses to pursue.
A kind of exploration to the students, to the candidates who actually wants to make their career into various technology, management, healthcare, in different areas, because the opportunities are endless.
Among the youths that gathered for guidance is Douglas Onenchan, who innovated a device that can be used by the visually impaired to see without assistance from any person.
This device is called eye by orits. So it's a combination of three words, an eye by orits. Yeah. So the eye is because this device is an equivalent of a real biological eye. How, why do I say that? With this device, any blind person or any visually impaired person, when they put on this device, they are able to see exactly what is in the environment.
He appeals to the government for more support to enable various forms of innovation, since there is ability for technology to boost the country's exports. Report compiled by Joseph Baguma and Ismail Kasoha for the news.